This week on Maker Update, a cube on every corner, he's no good to me dead, a planer that stays out of your way, and the creative benefit of spooky cabins.
Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we don't make mistakes, we just swear a lot and call it a happy accident. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got an awesome show for you, so let's check out the project of the week.
One of the most fundamental shapes in geometry is the cube. And one of the most fundamental truths of the cube is that it cannot stand on one of its corners. At least until Mircenk gets a hold of one. In his Instructable, he shows you how to build this 3D printed mechanical sculpture that allows you to balance a cube on its edge and on one of its points. The cube is balanced by three reaction wheels on three of its faces, similar to the ISS and other microgravity objects. Those reaction wheels are each powered by a trio of Nidec 24H servo motors. These are fairly affordable, high-speed servo motors that can be controlled directly from your microcontroller and without any motor driver. What's more, they also have an internal encoder, so you can use them for closed-loop motor applications. The reaction wheels are 3D printed, and he's included several holes so you can add fasteners to help balance out any weight imperfections in the 3D print. The control hardware in the project consists of an Arduino Nano, an MPU6050 IMU, and an optional Bluetooth module for easier tuning of the balance. There's a bit of wiring and routing to be done, but nothing that looks too complex. But what you get is this visually astonishing piece of tech. I mean, how many times have you seen a cube stand perfectly on one of its corners? You get to see him demonstrate its adaptability by placing it on an incline, adding weights, and perturbing the balance. And while it's so cool to see the reaction wheels working in the skeletal version of this, I feel like this project is screaming to be reskinned as a science fiction prop. Whatever you want to do with this project, it's yours to create. It's all open source, and you can get the files down in the description. More projects. Have you ever thought, I would like to be encased in carbonite? Okay, probably not, but Adam Savage isn't your average bear. When he recently upgraded his Han Solo carbonite prop with a new shell, he was left with a leftover enclosure. Waste not, want not is the way, and Adam contacted his VFX friends at FBFX in London, who had previously captured his 3D scan, to make an almost ready-made Adam Savage carbonite kit. Almost. After laying out the templates for the base, his body, his feet, and then his face, he then reshaped the hands to better fit the prop. Instead of creating a massive vacuum cast for the project, he instead creates a resin coating for the whole piece, adding texture and color as he goes. It's a really cool project and a fantastic result. From Get Hands Dirty, she's got a new video about upgrades to her central workbench. If you know her work, she's always optimizing for a really small workspace. This video is all about making a lift table for a bench planer. Come for the lift table, but stay for the other bench table building tips. Like her approach to using good drawer slide hardware for her workbenches, since she uses these more often than she might even use in her bedroom or kitchen. If it's something you use all the time, make it good to use. Seriously, I can't recommend this channel enough for shop build tips. They're fantastic. And on Instructables, I learned about this self-playing ukulele bot by Zeroshot. There's a lot to cover with the logistics here, but the basics are the separate mechanisms for plucking versus strumming. He's got a slider that moves the pick across all the strings, and it also carries a servo to do the strumming. But there's still more to do. To make sure the right notes get hit, there's also a solenoid-activated fret bar to keep playing the right notes. Like any project that seems simple at the start, the problems that need solving keep piling up, which makes the payoff of hearing it play a song all the more worth it. Now for some tips and tools. Support material has always been one of the most frustrating and disappointing aspects of 3D printing. And Uncle Jessy wants to help you get the best out of it. He's developed a custom 3D print test probe for multiple print resolutions to help you dial in your support settings for the best results and minimum resolution loss from support materials. Check it out. Whether you're building miniatures, props, or cosplay pieces, sooner or later, you're going to want to add some lighting elements. Valentin Felder is busy at work creating a lighting controller to give you precision levels of control on LEDs, addressable LEDs, and even incandescent bulbs. His video gives you a full tour of the board, including a tutorial on the difference between linear and log dimming, voltage regulation, and more. And from Gareth's Tips, Tools, and Shop Tales newsletter, we've got a beautiful crop of tips this week. If you're looking for an affordable airbrush system, they've got you covered. The Essential Craftsman has a breakdown of his own everyday carry, and you don't want to miss that. There's a great tip on how to remove kinks from your USB cables, and Project Farm has a guide on the best cheap toolkit you can buy today. But the best tip might come from Martina of Nerdforge. She spent 2 weeks in off-grid cabins painting to reinforce her artistic craft. It's always good to get out of your regular element to spark your creativity, but it's also a good idea to cut yourself off from distractions to let you really explore your creativity. Even if all you get out of a trip like this is a proper vacation, I'm sure you'll benefit from it. Try it out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Becky Stern wants to help you understand your car a little better. With all the tech under the hood in modern cars and pretty much anything made in the last 2 decades, it's really easy to feel like they've gotten away from us. Becky shows you how to get critical data from your car's OBD2 port and has a lengthy interview with a car security expert to get a better understanding of how cars can be secured and how they can be compromised. Tons of great stuff to learn here. Check it out. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. And remember, you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Big thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this whole show possible, and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.